Warp speed is the fastest speed imaginable, mainly because it's faster than the fastest thing proven to even exist. Warp speed has made it onto the big screen, the big household screen, the regular screen, the small screen, and the please don't watch this on your phone screen. But is the warp drive possible? For those of you who, somehow, don't know what the warp drive is basically a mechanism a starship uses to travel faster than the speed of light. And as you hopefully know, light is the fastest known object in the universe. So warp ships, like the Enterprise, is traveling faster than the fastest known object ever discovered. However, when Einstein discovered that light can travel at such speeds, he never said anything about a cosmic speed limit. He just pointed out that light travels at the fastest speed in real life. It's like driving on a highway where one car traveling at 60 miles per hour is the fastest on that highway, but the real speed limit is 75 miles per hour. Scientists in Italy have discovered that neutrinos might travel faster than light does, but this is up for debate. To achieve light speed, you need either no mass, like light itself, or have infinite energy. Neither one of those is easy to obtain, though. Solar sails have been theorized to be able to get up to near-light speeds using sunlight the same way a sailboat uses wind. Unfortunately, if you wanted to use finite energy and have mass, you would only be able to travel at around 99.999 etc. percent the speed of light, and you would also very quickly run out of fuel. Now, if warp ships need a lot of fuel, chemical rockets would never work. But there is something that you could use instead, antimatter. When a matter particle and an antimatter particle collide, they annihilate each other in huge, nuclear-like explosions. These explosions could be funneled through a thruster tube and used to propel a spacecraft forwards. But how do you store something in large quantities that would annihilate its container? Well, scientists have created a new element called positronium, and it is made of an electron and a positron, or an anti-electron. Now, antimatter is extremely potent, which is why I bought it up, and just a tiny amount of antimatter could get you from Earth to Mars. For every 1 billion subatomic antimatter particles, there are 1 billion one matter subatomic particles. This doesn't sound like much, but there are much more than 2 billion one subatomic particles in the universe. Matter is the fundamental building block of the universe, while antimatter is almost non-existent, basically. So the price of antimatter is very, very high. But what if instead of physically moving the spacecraft, we expanded and contracted space-time around the spacecraft? Well, that's exactly what Mexican scientist Miguel Alcubierre proposed in the 1990s. With this method, a spacecraft could reach Alpha Centauri in just 6 months, rather than light's 4.4 years, using 65 exajoules of energy. And yeah, that's a lot of electricity. It's about the amount of electricity in the United States of America consumes in an entire year, which you know is a lot if you've ever been to a large American city. But it's something we can create, at least. Since you've made it to the end of this video, why not give it a like and send it at warp speed to your friends and family by sharing it? And if you really like our videos, you should definitely consider subscribing. Stay Trekkie, my friends.